thank you very much for your short introduction, Mirza, and for the possibility to speak here today. As Professor Podobnik already has addressed it, consumer rights protection also means the protection of personal data, and this also means data security. And I will talk to you about special data security issues. And during the next 25 minutes, I would like to give you a short overview of the international legal regulation of cybersecurity, starting with the European law as well as the German law. And we'll have a short outlook onto the cybersecurity regulation in Russia and China, as well as in the United States. And I will end with a short outlook and conclusion. So firstly, as I announced it, we'll start with the German and European laws. So we had a so-called German IT Security Act in 2015. We have the European Network Information Security Directive. Legislation process was finished in 2016, and there is an ongoing legislative procedure for the European Cybersecurity Act, which might be finished this year in 2018. So to start with the German law, the first one here in the row, German did not have a special IT security law for the data protection and data security issues before. And for this reason, the German parliament decided to develop the so-called IT Security Act of Germany, and it came into force in 2015. And this has been a so-called Artikelgesetz, an omnibus law. It was only an amending act. That means it is called the IT Security Law of Germany. This is no codification that we have concerning IT security in Germany. It just amended various existing laws here, including the Act on the Federal Office for Information Security, the Atomic Energy Act, the Energy Industry Act, Telemedia Act for websites, Telecommunication Act, and the Act on the Federal Criminal Police Office. And this law came into force in 2015, and it's mainly, but not only, focused on the protection of critical infrastructure. So what is a critical infrastructure in the German law? So there is a catalog of them. We have energy, information technology, telecommunication, transport, traffic, health, water, food, finance, and insurance. Plus, there has to be a so-called relevance of failure consequences if such a critical infrastructure does not work properly. But, as I mentioned before, this law is not only referring to critical infrastructures for the protection of the country and the people living there. It also includes a general extension of the Federal Authority for Information Security of Germany. For example, the BSI has the possibility to issue warnings towards the consumers of some products, or to do an examination of IT security if there might be any IT security flaws for consumer products. And when we take a look onto the cybersecurity regulation on the European level, we find a similar situation compared to the situation in Germany, because there is also no codification for IT security issues. So we have numerous individual regulations with different legally binding nature. And this might be a problem because depending on the respective business or infrastructure sector, you as a company or as a consumer have to look onto different legal possibilities or different legal regulations. And a very important one, which had been discussed during the last 2 years, is the so-called Regulation on Electronic Identification and Trust Services for Electronic Transactions in the Internal Market, the EIDAS regulation of the European Union. And there is currently a very broad discussion about this law in Germany, as well as some research, which is funded by the Federal Ministry of Research and Education in Germany. And one key part of the European IT security strategy of the last years is the so-called Network Information Security Directive, which came into force in 2016. So it's a quite young law. And the European Union has defined the network information security very early as a key factor for the functioning of the internal market of the European Union, because many services or products are being sold through online services, and this is why the European Union addressed this topic explicitly in its recent legislation.
And as you may see, we had a relatively long-term legislative procedure here. So the first proposal of this law was issued in 2013, February, and the entry into force date was in 2016, in August. So it was quite a long legislative procedure. The reason is because there were many European member states who did not have any IT security authorities, no IT security regulation, and they did not want to have such a high level of IT security as it has been proposed firstly by the European Commission. And of course, it is not regulations that we have here, it's only a directive, so it's still the fact that we need a national implementing act. And for Germany, it's the so-called IT security law, which was slightly amended due to the European regulation. But the Network Information Directive is designed as a so-called global approach, covering common minimum capacity building and planning requirements, exchange of information, cooperation, and common security requirements for operations of essential services and so-called digital service providers. Digital service providers, for example, online marketplaces or online search engines or, for example, cloud computing providers. And when we take all this together, the legal regulation in the European Union and Germany about IT security and data security, we'll see that we have on one hand the operators or the companies, and on the other hand the federal authority of IT security. For each country, it's, I think it's the same, and we have a cooperation between them. And the operators, they have to implement IT security measures based on the state of the art, the technical state of the art. And they have to operate a so-called contact point to the Federal Authority of Information or Data Security. And when there are any data breaches or IT security flaws, the company has to provide information to the Federal Authority for IT Security. And well, they collect everything, they evaluate this information, and then they give it back via this contact point to the operators who evaluate everything again and put it into the information security or data security management system to have an adequate level of IT security. And this is also done in cooperation with the European Network and Information Security Agency. So this is a picture of how this all works together here. And we have a very interesting development in the European Union right now concerning IT security or data security with a new European Cybersecurity Act. And we have an ongoing legislative procedure here, as I announced it before. The procedure says that this legislative procedure will be finished in 2018, but I'm not sure about this because we are already back in the agenda, so there might be some problems finishing this legal act in 2018. But this new European Cybersecurity Act is a part of the newly announced European Cybersecurity Strategy by Jean-Claude Juncker in 2017, and it does not want to protect only the critical infrastructures or the so-called digital service providers, for example, online marketplaces. It also wants to protect the digital interior market in general. So this regulation is very important also for the consumer protections, data security. And for this reason, it is planned to have a comprehensive reorganization of the European Network Information Security Authority and a stronger exchange of information of IT security flaws or problems among the IT security authorities of the different member states of the European Union. And we also have, this is a core of this whole regulation, a new European IT security certification, which will make IT security certification easier throughout the whole European market, because when you as a company have an IT security certificate in one member state, you can use it in another member state as well. So it's much more easier to access other markets in the European Union. And concerning the legislative procedure, we already had two reports issued. The first one here from the European Parliament Committee on Civil Liberties, and the second one just a month ago, coming from the Internal Market and Consumer Protection Committee of the European Union. And they were also addressing some normative issues of the European Normative Association to put in the role of standards, technical norms and standards into this European regulation. And for, well, it is announced right now that we might have the plenary voting concerning this EU Cybersecurity Act in 2018. And this is an approach of Germany and Europe. And now we'll take a close look and a very short look onto the approach about data protection and IT security in Russia. And there we have a general political strategy, which is the so-called Russian cybersecurity doctrine, the first one coming from the year 2000, so quite old, and the second one from 2016. And based on this one, we have legislation there, the new Russian cybersecurity law, which came into force this year in January. So firstly, we had the first Russian cybersecurity doctrine in the year 2000, but it was quite anachronistic because it did not mention the internet. So, well, it was not useful to protect citizens or to protect the state against cybersecurity flaws. But based on that one, we had the second cybersecurity doctrine in the year 2016, which is also the new one. And the goal of this directive was to, or the doctrine, was the protection of the international interests of the Russian Federation in cyberspace. But it's a very interesting fact that this Russian IT security strategy, in comparison to the European one, is not based on any economic interests or protection of a digital market. It's mostly based on political and military interests. So completely different interests here that we find from the state. And this is also the reason why this second cybersecurity doctrine is very closely linked to the national security strategy of the Russian Federation. And for the Russian Federation, effective cybersecurity mainly includes the strengthening of the military, safeguarding digital weapon systems, protection of the national interests of Russian allies. So a completely different approach that we might find here. And based on this cybersecurity strategy, we have this new Russian cybersecurity law of 2018. And it's pretty new, as you may see, so it came into force in January. And the goal of this law is the foundation of a Russian-wide cybersecurity, national IT security system, with the aims of the detection, prevention, and elimination of any cybersecurity risk in the European Union. And the duties that we can find there are pretty similar to the German one and to the European one. So again, we have some technical and organizational measures which have to be taken into account by the companies. There are some duties to report to competent Russian authorities, and the Russian authorities will also introduce a so-called register of important IT infrastructure objects. And the Russian definition of critical information infrastructure is also broader than the German or the European one, for example, because we also have the infrastructure sectors of defense, mining, and chemical industry here. So you can see this approach is completely different to the European Union one. It's not economic based, and for this reason, it's also not consumer protection based. When you take a look onto the Chinese regulation, we have a new cybersecurity law on from 2016 and a so-called measures on security review of network products and services, which had been finalized in 2017. And the Chinese cybersecurity law is also pretty interesting because it has a so-called double focus. What does double focus mean? It is focused onto network security, so it means data security, as well as data protection. So here we have again a big difference to the German and the European law, because here in the European Union, IT security and data protection are completely separated from each other. So we have, for example, the Network Information Security Directive, which addresses data security and information security issues. And on the other hand, we have the General Data Protection Regulation, which is especially a special law about data protection. And China tries to put all these things together with a holistic approach to the IT security regulation. So that means the Chinese regulation, the new Chinese law, addresses IT security issues as well as data protection issues. And of course, when you have personal data, you also have to think about how to protect this data technically. And this is done here by the Chinese cybersecurity regulation. So when we split this up, the two focus topics here, network security and data protection, We'll see that the law describes that Chinese networks should be in a stable and reliable state of work. Measures should be taken against intrusions, destruction, or the unlawful use of network resources. And there are some technical and organizational duties for the companies as well as for private persons which are ongoing with that. For example, technical and organizational measures, there has to be a risk assessment concluded. Natural persons have to fulfill a real name registration. There's also information exchange, best practices, education, certification of cybersecurity, as well as very severe penalties towards individuals as well as the authorities. And we have also some data protection regulations in the new Chinese cybersecurity law. So that means protection of personal information, which allows any identification of individuals. And we'll find in this law some principles that are coming out of the European law. So for example, the confidentiality earmarking principle, the informed consent for the use of data, the regulation of privacy breaches, and the rights of the persons concerned. But all in all, it is to say that the Chinese data protection and data security level is lower than the European one that we find here. And the second legislation in China is the so-called measures on security review of network products and services. All in all is to say that the goal of this second legislation in China is improvement of security and controllability of IT network products and services. And this is based on the Chinese national security law as well as the Chinese cybersecurity law. And the measure to reach this goal is a cybersecurity review for so-called key products. So that means products which are very important for the industry or for the economy of the Chinese country. And the responsibility for these measures on security review of network products and services lies on the Chinese Cyberspace Administration, including some third parties and companies. And the process is an intense collaboration between all of the different companies which issue products or services concerning IT security, the use of personal data, or data security. And there's been a very broad discussion about this second Chinese regulation in Germany, as well as in some other countries. I've been in France last week, and I've been talking with some people of some companies, because as a company, when you have a product that you want to export to China and you will not gain the certification due to this law, then maybe the use of this product would be prohibited in China. So the Chinese government is taking a very close look onto the protection of its citizens and the protection of its network security information systems with this second legislation here. Finally, we'll talk about the United States law. And there we have the Cybersecurity National Security Action Plan, which is another word for the cybersecurity strategy of the United States, and the Cybersecurity Information Sharing Act coming from 2015. And the Cybersecurity National Security Action Plan, CNAP, defines some measures and some strategies for the protection of individuals as well as companies against cyber attacks. And here we have a variety of sector-specific regulations in the US, in the United States concerning IT security on the national level as well as on the level of the federal state. So here again, the situation is quite complicated, but we might expect it. Self-regulation is a very important topic in the US, and self-regulation can also be found here in the field of data security and also in the field of data protection for the individuals. And I've written down here some examples of sector-specific laws on the national level which are addressing data protection and data security issues. So firstly, they are sorted by the date of coming into force. So firstly, the Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act, which is about the data security of electronically stored medical data, where there had been some major data breaches for hospital data, for example, in the recent years in the US. The Financial Services Modernization Act, also called Gramm-Leach-Bliley Act from 1999, about the data security of financial institutions. The Federal Information Security Management Act coming from 2002 about security data processing of federal authorities. And finally, the Cybersecurity Information Sharing Act, from 2015, which defines an information exchange among IT security relevant authorities. And if there are any insufficient IT security measures of the companies, this may be sanctioned by the Federal Trade Commission. So this is also the same situation that we have or that we can find for the data protection in the US, because concerning the newly found privacy shield, there's also the Federal Trade Commission, which is a supervisory authority for data protection in the United States. So to come to a conclusion and to a short outlook of this presentation, so firstly, we have seen that there are many different approaches for cybersecurity on the international level during the recent years. So it's a very hot topic because there have been many security flaws throughout the European Union as well in the United States during the last years. So it's a very hot topic. And Germany and Europe are trying to address the cybersecurity and data protection issues on from the scratch. So they want to make a legislation which takes care about all of the data protection and data security issues in a completely new legislation. And we also have some current technological changes which force national states to promote cybersecurity legislation. For example, Japan, where there is a new legislative approach, especially for IoT devices, because IoT is pretty common in Japan, more than it is here in the European Union. But cybersecurity is not only a legal question or a legal issue, but also a task for this international standardization. So that means we have to think about how we can concretize the legal cybersecurity requirements, how we can support a consistent interpretation of newly introduced laws with indefinite legal terms. And of course, we also need the international norms and standards, the technical standards, as a means to conduct the transnational cybersecurity certifications throughout the European Union. So thank you very much for your attention.